day. Thank you for joining us on today's edition of the program, Woman to Woman. I am Adorable Adesuwa Osa Uwagie. It's usually violence against women. You know, when there is domestic violence, the woman plays the victim most times. Or other times, the woman is always the victim. But this time around, we want to look at violence against the men. Women are taking up arms against their partners, their husbands, you know, their fiancés and all of that. What could be responsible for this? Not too long ago, the Supreme Court affirmed the judgment of a lower court to say that a certain woman must die by hanging. What did she do? She stabbed her husband to death. Why? Because the man, according to her, was into other women and all of that. If she couldn't take it, why did she not work? That is the question a lot of people were asking. But the deed has been done. She's been sentenced to death. The man is long gone. Why did she get to that point of anger? You may want to ask. In another instance not too long ago, a woman was so angry, she cut off the genitals of the husband. She cut off his private parts because she saw him with another woman. Somewhere, another woman got pregnant for another woman's husband, and the woman took up arms against her husband. What is happening to women? Why is there so much anger in the heart of the woman? We're not talking about a particular woman now. We're talking about women in general. It is happening in Nigeria, just as it is happening in all the parts of the world. Women are killing their partners. Women are maiming their partners. Women are destroying the lives of their children. Because when you kill your partner, what are you doing to your children? You're destroying their lives, and the children would know. So these are many more we're going to be looking at on the program, Woman to Woman. So join me as I make welcome two delectable, beautiful women as we talk about violence against the men, violence coming from the woman now to the men. So let me make welcome Princess Bola Akalami. It's nice to have you in the studio.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, she's a beautiful woman and, of course, a public commentator.
Thank you so much.
And an astute politician.
Thank you.
So it's nice to have you in the studio. And did I mention an award winner?
Yes,
for the cause of women. Yeah.
Thank you.
I have another public commentator, a beautiful woman, a woman who runs the cause of women too, who is there for the sake of women and children. She fights for justice for the women. So join me as I make welcome Didi Ekpeyong. I kind of like that your name, oh, Didi. Reminds me of Agidi. Agidi Didi, you know? Don't mind me. All right, ladies. Women are beginning to take arms against themselves. Usually, when we talk about domestic violence, we usually see the woman as the victim. When we talk about domestic violence, some women play the victim. Meanwhile, they are not the victim. They're actually the villains, as the case may be. What is happening to the women who are supposed to be the soft vessel, you know? Soft, easy women, so to speak. What is happening to the psyche of today's woman? Princess Bola Akalami, you're nearest to me, so.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I really want to talk about what is violence. Violence is a physical force, such as injure the other person, killed, and we have emotional violence also. What we want to talk today is about women
perpetrating violence
against
men,
you know. So, what commons, what we see these days, women being the one, being the victim. But in this case, we've seen a lot in recent time that women are now the one beating up their husband, injuring their husband, do all sorts of things to their husband. But we look at it. First of all, what leads to that incident? One, provocation. sometimes the man will make sure that the woman didn't get whatever she wants to get. Two, sexual
satisfaction.
Sometimes the man will go out there and be doing all sorts of things to with another woman.
Okay.
Whereas the woman,
he's
at home,
his wife.
At home, he didn't get the sexual satisfaction, you know. So that leads to the anger in the woman. Mm. So because of that, when the man comes home, bring out the anger, and before you need, they start fighting. And that leads to a violence against the men.
Okay, Didi, Princess, have gone in depth into this. What's your take on women taking arms against their men? Whether husband, whether boyfriend, whether fiancé, fiancé, or whatever name they call, but their partners.
Okay, thank you so much. I think it's a generational thing.
Times generational.
And women too are getting more aware of themselves, of who they are, of what they can do, of what is happening to them. In time past, some crazy things could be happening around a man, around a woman. The man will be aware, but the woman will just be there innocently. Now, women are no longer innocent. They don't just stay in the house. They are not just in the home. They go out, they walk. Let's take, for example, a woman is working. End of the year, it's her vacation. And the man is not taking his. She goes on vacation. She meets another man. She has fun more than what she normally sees in the house.
From the husband.
Then December is over, January, she comes home. She's going to be acting out. She's going to, the man is not like exactly as nice as the other. He's going to be comparing. Things are going to go wrong. Mm. Now, it's because she is no longer in the home. She's now working. It's not like working is a bad thing. But she's not exposed to other things and she's like, wow, so it can be like this. And now I'm talking about variety. She's not seeing it in the home.
But she didn't have any business meeting another man, for goodness
but
sake.
But you're on vacation, you must meet
when
people.
When she has a husband.
Yes, but it's happening and we cannot close our eyes to it. I spoke to a female lawyer that told me that during December, they just sit down, they brace themselves because they know the vacation will soon be over and a lot of divorce cases will start coming
in January,
February. What is causing it?
Okay.
So that's the trend. That's what they are seeing. So I'm thinking, is it the vacation they went to? Somebody's like, I'm visiting my mother in Toto Village and the man is like, I can't come with you. Okay, she's going alone.
So the man is not always there for the woman.
You know, not always being there. And as I'm saying it, it's about variety. They go there, they want some kind of like sexual variety and you're just giving it one way and they're like, just trying to be adventurous. Whether it's right or wrong, they don't really care.
So sexual and frustration could lead to all of
at
that.
At times, maybe it's just anger or some form of retribution. They're like, I saw this text message in his phone. He must be doing something. Why can't I? I can pay him back. I don't have to fight with him. But if he feels he can do it, I too can go ahead and do it. And things happen and the next thing, the woman is acting out in the home.
But that's quite and wrong.
It's wrong, but that's what we are seeing in our society because women are getting more exposed. The more educated, the more exposed they become, it's becoming something else. They can no longer tolerate.
Why didn't she just take a walk instead of, you know, turning to violence?
It's not everybody that will take a walk. Some women will actually take a walk. But it's not everybody that, everybody can be the same. You know, so it's happening and we can't deny the fact that these things are going on. And at times you just see a woman so emotionally traumatized. Maybe she's feeling my mates are having some things I'm not having. My husband is not paying enough attention to me. Maybe there's someone else or something. Just, it could be anything or she could be mentally ill. And we won't know she's mentally ill. And one day she just gets up and is cutting off the man or doing something more terrible. And we're like, what is happening?
So how did women get to that point, that height of anger, that height of carelessness, so to speak, to the point that they let themselves go? And when they are being challenged by their husband in the house, the next thing is to pick up one object or the other to harm the man.
They are not self-control. They don't have self-control. because most times we must have self-control, because sometimes when you see some certain things, you know, let me not put it this way, the devil or whatever.
No, they will always call the devil.
Sometimes the thoughts will be there, but when you have self-control, that no, this thing, if I should do it, is very bad. The outcome will not be good at all. For the sake of my children, for the sake of people around me, no, I can't do it. So when you have self-control, even when your husband is pushing you to anger, you just have that self-control and you just have to say, no, I can't do this. You know, that is the remedy. Well, but when you don't have self-control.
Let me ask you some question. Exactly yes. What can a man do to a woman that can bring a woman to that point of anger,
to that point of destructive anger, to say that I will do this. A man doesn't need to do much. So many things are going on. We are hearing of gender equality, women emancipation. We are hearing of so many things. Now they are women are being educated that, oh, you can't just take this shit from a man. You can't, you too, you have your own rights, equal rights, gender equality. This is, look, a man doesn't have to do much in the house.
That's not enough.
It's not enough, but it is ringing in the brains of women. We too, we are something. We don't have to be. This submission they talk about is the thing is in the past. We don't have to be so submissive. We don't have to be. We too, we are human beings.
Are we derailing from the traditional role of the woman?
We are not
now
going so traditional
of,
anymore. The tradition
education.
Is no longer. Oh my
for
God!
For me, I'm not in support of that.
It's no longer there.
No matter
there.
What the man do to you,
okay,
don't take a harm. Don't take a revenge on the man. Better still walk away. But because sometimes what really brought this violence against men is when the woman is pushed to the world. Well, like when the man always beats the woman. Because sometimes when the man beats the woman all the time, you see the woman want to react that, oh, you want to start again. Today, I will show you that I'm a woman. So because before you knew it,
that means she has taken enough beating. She has been pushed to the wall. No escape route anymore. Today I really want to deal with this man.
You know, by the time woman start talking like this, before you knew it will lead to something else. It will lead to death, trauma in the house. A lot of things will go wrong when woman take this kind of decision. Sometimes when man take the decision like this, the man may calm down, but it's not easy for a woman to calm down at that particular time, because most time men may come out there and take a drink and talk to a friend, but women are so secretive. Even when something is happening in the house, even when they are being victimized in the house, you see woman want to take that action.
Why is it difficult for a woman to come out to say that? Because we've come to realize that a lot of us women, we pretend a lot.
Of course.
Oh, we pretend a lot, whether to protect the family or the children or even the man. Okay, you find your man cheating.
Yes.
Some women have actually caught their men in the act of cheating. Some may even know the women the men are cheating with.
Of course.
They could even be the friends of the wife. Yeah. Or friends of their kids, or friends of their sisters. Is somebody known to them? Some women have actually, you know, caught their husband in the act. Is it not possible for that woman to calm down? Like that little boy said in that video that went viral, be calming down and all
very,
of that.
Very, very possible. Very possible.
But some women have said that cheating is something they cannot forgive. Like Didi said, some women have seen it happen and they have decided that okay, they are going to take their pound of flesh.
No,
they go into the streets.
It doesn't
forgive.
Mean that it is right.
No, you forgive.
It doesn't mean that it is right. And when you say forgive, it's not everybody that can forgive. We all have this elasticity limits. There's a level to what we can take. You can just get to a point you can't take it anymore. At that point, a woman can choose to be sane.
As a man ever cheated on you,
Didi? Talking from experience, I've been cheated on several times. I took a walk.
Okay, but you didn't have to.
I didn't have to kill you or hurt you or something.
You took a walk.
Once I smell it, I'm out. There's no way of telling me you're sorry, because there's no sorry that's going to erase.
But as
that
a woman,
shit.
You're supposed to be patience.
Patience.
You're supposed to persevere.
Let me tell you what it's going to do.
You're supposed to be submissive.
No, you're not.
You're supposed to honor your man with everything that you have.
No, are we talking about infidelity?
We are in Africa.
We're talking about violence against a man.
Violence against a man. Yes. You don't have to go that way. If it happens, think of your life. Women go about thinking, how should I harm the man? What you should be thinking about is, how do I get to a lab? How do I check myself that I've not been infected with an STD? How do I check that I am okay, I can walk away and still be healthy and fine? How do I check myself that I'm so healthy that I can be in another relationship? How do I check myself to make sure that he has not given me HIV? We just go about being silly, thinking of how to kill the man. We should actually be thinking of ourselves. Are we okay? You caught your man cheating. Did he protect himself while he was cheating? There are more important issues to look into.
For me, cheating...
It's not about going to kill the man. Because make sure you are good first.
I understand that.
Make sure you are fine.
As a woman, I know that cheating is one of those things that make a woman really mad. You know, it gets that woman angry.
Yes.
But the ability to calm down, the ability to like exercise some restraints before you act is what we're talking about. But unfortunately, some women will look at it and say, okay, nothing do me. I'm cool. But they wait till night under the covers of darkness and they strike the man.
No, it's for that.
Where is the forgiving spirit of the woman who is supposed to be the weaker vessel? Who is supposed to be a homemaker?
That's the question I'm asking. That's for women that are morally stable. It's not every woman that is stable enough to reason that way. Maybe the learned ones, they could go like, okay, let's sit down and think about these things.
The one that happened in Abuja is between learned couples.
Learned couples.
Of course.
So they are quite educated.
So the insanity level just shuts up.
The educated one, they are the one doing all of this. You know? I can remember, in those days, you don't have a number of divorcee so high like
we
these
have
days.
Now.
Violence, you don't have, even when your husband have like five wives,
you
in
even
those days,
go and look
they,
for them
they
to,
have,
so that the man can
they,
marry
they
them.
Can, they
you know,
that
was
the women endure you know? With their husband, the children endure. But these days, the problem we have these days is that we don't have patience. We don't want to be patient. Everything, this man did this to me, I'm going to get out of the house. Why can't we settle? Why can't you settle first?
It's emotional pain.
That's the emancipation I'm talking about.
But we can still settle it. Like the recent that happened, Governor Autumn, the one that happened between the doctor and the media
and
guy.
The media guy, yeah.
You saw it.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, they can't just get away like that.
But the woman cried out.
The
woman cried out.
She did the right thing.
Women don't cry out.
They just keep it.
They bottle it up.
They
bottle that anger. They bottle that pain. And then when they explode, it's either they burst or they break into pieces. You understand what I'm saying? The woman cried out. And women came out to judge this woman. That why did she wash her dirty linen in public? Why did she bring a marriage matter to public? Why did she allow people to know what was going on
because
in her marriage?
So
I think I want to salute that woman's courage for coming to cry.
Obvious.
It was a cry for mercy.
Yes, for help.
How do you explain, I wasn't there, judging by what the woman said. How do you explain a man sitting on a woman's stomach
for 4 weeks?
And you're saying if that woman had the will, she wouldn't have done something crazy to that man that she may regret.
Thank God he didn't do anything bad.
Well, we should be grateful to God for that.
And
that
for
she
men,
cried out.
And for the men that goes through pains, violence, most times what they do is that they don't talk. The men don't talk when they go through violence. And what they do is that they divorce the woman in questions. And most times you don't get to know what really happened in the home. Because the man won't say anything. He will just tell you that, no, that woman, I don't want to marry that woman again because she is not good for me.
The man is protecting his dignity.
That is it. Because you don't want to say that
when a woman beating up her husband.
It's very bad. The woman is very giant, you know. Why the man is
kind of dwarf.
So, I saw it. Then I was even a little when I saw it. The woman always beat up the man. The man don't have control in the house. You know, even when the man collects salary from the office, he give it to the woman. You know, the woman demanded for it that bring that because he's not afraid of the woman. So because of that, you see, most times there will not be growth in that house when you start beating up your because first of all, fear will come in. The man will not be able to take responsibility of the house. The fear will be there. The trauma will be there.
Why do women make a lot of trouble? You know, particularly if this woman is the breadwinner. She earns more than the man. And then she's like, she brings the bulk of the money that is spent in the home. And before you know what is happening, the woman wants to be master.
That is what is happening.
And by nature, men would not accept that. It is not in their nature to be subservient to the woman. Instead, it's the other way around. But unfortunately, some women want to be the oga. They want to be the captain of the boat because they bring more money. Should it be that way?
It shouldn't be. Because, first of all, even when you are bringing all those things, but most times, when things like that happen is when the man comes up and said he want to was now the one that want to take all the decision even when the woman is bringing it the money, they should compensate the woman by doing some certain things. For instance, when the woman goes out to get a job or to do business
to bring money home
and you want to override the woman with everything. Sit down there. There is this person, I don't want to mention a name now, that complains to me that he is a doctor. The man is a doctor. At the end of the day, she is the one bringing up the money. Why the man going out there taking girls, sleeping with girls,
and spending
money on other girls? Whereas the woman will bring everything. And at the end of the day, the woman wants to go out there. He have a lot of job out there that he wants to go to another hospital where they can even give her 2 days. He will work there 2 days, will get 100. And the mom deprived the woman of that. So the woman was very angry. He was even saying that, it's like, I want to leave this man because he's now in a higher rank than the man, and they enter the upcoming hospital together. So he passed his exam many times than the man. So because of that, the anger,
jealousy
came. And whenever the woman dress up, he will now say, "Where are you going to?" Even when he knows that he's going to an office and they are going to the same office, he will now say, "No, okay, help me to take these children to school because you know, I have this thing this afternoon, and you are in the evening this thing. Duty. So please help me." He will now tell you, "No, I can't even do that." You see the anger. The woman is now developing a lot of anger. Before you need it, will fight back and say, "No, I won't take this anymore." But we don't encourage that. We don't encourage any woman to fight back.
Okay.
Because when you fight back, it may even hurt you. And at the process, you may even get injured at the process. So don't fight back. The little thing I can say is, first of all, you can go to your counselor, which is sometimes your pastor.
How many people use counselors
these days? You can go to your pastors, and when you see that the man persists, you know, better still, you walk away.
Okay, Didi, time is not our friend. What are the things a woman should put in place to curb anger, to manage her anger, so that it does not get up to that point of killing the husband or maiming him? What are the things
the
a woman
is,
should
it,
do?
It still boils down to one thing, communication. Communicate. Make your husband your friend. Play with him. Talk with him. Don't just feel that, everything is fine all the time. If you notice anything, talk it out with him.
What if the man is not willing to hear?
Don't bottle in things. If he's not ready, before you go into a marriage, make sure that he talks. During the counseling, make sure that communication thing, that's important. The genesis of all the problems. If it's not working, if you can't communicate, there's going to be a lot of issues. Once you're able to talk, you're playing with him, he's playing with you, and the next one is like, this lady, you know, the way she was talking to me the other day. Just playfully, you could just be talking, and you know that, oh, there's something happening or about to happen, and before you know it, both of you trash it out. Stop keeping secrets.
Okay, so Bola, as a last word, what's your advice to women who have the tendency of picking arms against their husband or perpetrating violence against their husbands?
Please, any woman that is going through anything, difficulties in your home, even when the man is provoking you seriously, please don't take harm. Look unto God. Talk to God about it. You know, take your husband to God. You know, talk to God that, God, please arrest this man for me. And God will do that. Please, don't take any harms. Don't beat up your husband, no matter what he does. Please don't do that. That is the only advice I have for
you. Okay, ladies, communication, prayers, perseverance, patience. These are some of the key factors that you should, as a matter of urgency, embrace so that you don't find yourself maiming or killing your partner. Violence is not the answer. If you cannot, I'm not an advocate of divorce, but if you cannot stand the heat, you should get out of the kitchen. But let your reasons be cogent enough. Let's stop maiming those we're supposed to love. We'll see you again on another episode of the program, Woman to Woman. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, bye-bye.